Well, I think one of the first thing I'm going to do is to make sure that we don't give golden parachutes to executive directors that basically don't do anything. $500,000 was a little bit too much, and that's something that I would not have done. I think there's a couple of things. Part of my agenda as running for mayor is that in the year 2020, I want to have at least 100,000 more riders in our muni system, in addition to take out 50,000 individuals so that they don't they're not dependent on our cars. And so those are the benchmarks that I'm going to be evaluated against relative to my mayorship. And so how do we do that? I think there's a couple things. Number one, we've got to ensure that there's technology that is utilized to help plan our muni and run our muni. What do I mean by that? Number one, it seems to me that we ought to be using a more real-time demand-based ridership and trains and bus allocations for our muni system, and so that we will in fact, muni will in fact know what is the demand for a particular line, for a either train line or a bus line, so that we can allocate the appropriate assets to accomplish moving people from point A to point B. And then also helping the operators to have real-time understanding about their schedule so that they know if they are on time or they're not on time, and helping them adjust their operation of the vehicles accordingly. I think the other is that we've got to really look at how we allocate dollars so that we spend the dollars more appropriately. For example, there are many vehicles that we send out on a daily basis where parts are broken or parts are just simply band-aid together. And when you have that kind of situation, you're going to have breakdowns. And it is those kinds of breakdowns that reduces the trust and confidence in the ridership that muni understands what's going on, know what's happening. And those are some of the things that I would be doing. Well, a lot of times what happens with City Hall is that whenever they have a problem, they blame workers. And that's the last thing I'm going to do. I'm not going to end up pointing fingers at, well, it's the muni operators that's creating the problem. It is those work rules that they are working under that's causing the problem. Look, we've got to deal with a lot of issues relative to muni in terms of its operations, in terms of its morale, in terms of its efficiency, a number of things. But the way in which we're going to solve those particular problems is really working with everyone. It doesn't do us any good to point the fingers at the operators and think you're going to solve the problem by then blaming them for the difficulties that we're having with muni. And so with the issue of overtime and with the issue of how do you maintain the budget, well, you do it by working with the operators and helping them understand, what is it, what's the challenge that we have, and I believe that we can, in fact, accommodate the difficulties of keeping our budget in line. I think specifically, we ought to be looking at, how we can, in fact, hire additional operators so that you don't have this situation of having to pay individuals overtime. I think if you look at what the demands is, and then from there look at how many staff you have, I think you can in fact reduce that overtime quite nicely. Well, there's a number of things. I think again, what I indicated earlier is that I would not be giving golden parachutes to the top administrators. I would look at how we can reduce some of the management individuals within its ranks. I would make sure that whoever runs muni understands what transportation is and how do we handle a major transportation system like in San Francisco. We ought not to be making appointments to the MTA based on political consideration. So up and down the ranks, up and down the organizational structure, I would make sure that, number one, that individuals have experience running a multifaceted system such as Muni. I would make sure that individual has had the experience of doing that, so it's not just knowledge base but also experience. And then I think finally, at the end of the day, look, I'm going to try and get more riders into Muni. It's absolutely critical. We cannot be dependent on our cars to move from point A to point B. And so if we're going to need revenue, I'm more than happy to look at additional revenue, but I'm going to lead by making Muni a lot more efficient, a lot more professional, and then out of that, increasing the ridership within Muni.